Sérieux là?
Alors ça, c'est bien français.
Ma santé, t'en as absolument rien à foutre quoi.
Ma santé, ben je sais pas.
C'est exactement ça. Oh, salut! Hey guys! You know what? I can't wait to dive into this video because today I'm going to talk about how we do meals in France and the different types of meals that we do in these three categories: with family, with friends, and on a date. So let's dive in and let's look at how the French eat. Meal scenario number one, eating with your family. So eating is a huge part of French culture, and eating with a family is a must. While some families eat almost three meals together, that's right, some of them really try to gather and regroup at dinner and share their day.
J'ai fait du ragout.
What's funny with the French culture is that sometimes during our meals is also the time where people get in arguments. So let's check out this short clip that shows just that.
Comme d'hab, j'avais mangé trop de pain parce que l'apéro avait duré 2 heures et 34 minutes. Et comme d'hab, il parlait politique parce que l'apéro avait duré 2 bouteilles et 34 verres.
Tu peux pas dire ça.
Mon oncle dit vraiment trop de gros mots.
Mais qu'elle aille se faire.
Gros mots.
Je te jure, oui.
Gros mots.
Cette
gros mots.
Guys, so what's funny with this, in this video is that you're seeing a family and the family dynamics. So you're seeing, you know, each person having their personality. And in France, as you just saw, every person is sitting down at the table. They are eating together. Even if this video is funny more than anything, and you can watch the whole thing, it's just this series called Bref, which is brief, just like the name is. But you see the family dynamics and how they all interact, and then they're having a meal together, they're eating together, and that is how it is in France. Like, you usually eat every single dinner together in most families. So growing up in France, my brother and I would have breakfast in the morning before we'd head out to school. My dad usually made it. And then at lunch, we had about an hour to an hour and a half, I don't remember exactly, lunch break. So we'd go back to the house, walk back, and eat lunch with my mom and dad. Most of the time my dad was there, he would also take a lunch break from the office and come out and have lunch with us. And isn't that crazy? But that is how the French culture is, because a lot of people have a 2-hour lunch break from work, and that's when often they can regroup with family members. But dinner is kind of sacred. Dinner is when the family really regroups and gets to kind of talk about the day, what went on, and usually the mom cooks, sometimes the dad, you know, just depends on how you're raised, whatever it is. But everybody as a family has dinner together. And we do have dinner a little later than in the US or other English-speaking countries per se. I think we had dinner at like 7:30, and that was kind of, well, not early, but just kind of normal. So it's very typical to have dinner at 7, 8, even 9 o'clock at night. So that is the family meal, and sometimes the dynamics around the family table can be interesting, whether you're talking about work, whether you're talking about school, what's going on in the day. Very interesting dynamic, but the family is like, they cook together, they do all this together, and that's a very important part of the culture.
Alors t'es allé où finalement?
Au but.
Ah ouais? Et alors?
Hein?
Moving on to meals with friends in France. So whether your family or whether your friends are like family, dinner is or any meal time is a moment to regroup, and people spend a long time at the table talking, discussing things, and it is an important part of everyday life. In the next few clips we're gonna look at, you're gonna see how friends, and especially close friends, gather together and eat sitting together, and they're sharing a common meal. In terms of cooking, there always seems to be one that tends to be kind of the one leading all the cooking, but people are helping out, doing their part. But people do sit together, they have a certain etiquette in terms of like how the fork and knife is placed. Some people really make it all fancy and have the napkin, you know, that's folded nicely. And then there's always moments and usually hours of discussion, laughter. Sometimes people play games, but then they kind of veer that off. And as you'll notice, wine seems to be an important part of most meals, or beer.
La raclette, c'est un truc qu'on mange en famille, entre proches. Pour ce con qui met la poêle au-dessus alors que c'est fait pour les patates.
Bah quoi?
Il y a toujours ce débat avec ou sans croûte.
What? Tu manges pas ta croûte? Attends, moi je mange que ça.
Il y a toujours une embrouille sur à qui appartient quoi.
Attends, ça c'est ma pomme de terre.
C'est à tout le monde les pommes de terre en fait.
Non, non, celle-ci je l'avais réservée.
Il y a toujours un mec qui se prend pour un chef cuistot, et puis surtout, il y a toujours Gilles Raclette qui ramène sa science. Alors ça, en fait, c'est pas de la vraie. Hein. La vraie raclette traditionnelle suisse, c'est un demi-fromage qu'on racle, d'où le nom raclette, ça vient de là.
Ah bah donc t'en veux pas alors?
Ah bah si, j'en veux quand même.
Ah bah non, attends, c'est pas traditionnel, je vais quand même pas te laisser manger ça, tu rigoles.
Tu bois du vin, bah ça devient du vin chaud. Ah, ton avant-bras est carrément carbonisé, t'as le visage rouge écarlate et la tête prête à exploser. T'as pas la clim?
I just love Norman fait des vidéos, he has such good videos and I'm gonna show you more, but he just pretty much shows everyday life in France and it's not even for those who may be interested in the culture learning French. It's just things that are funny but actually that are real. So here he's showing the raclette. I mentioned that different meals in France are themed based, so to speak, and so raclette is a traditional French dish where you pour melted cheese on potatoes, on different types of meats, on pickles, on vegetables, and so forth, and usually something that people do in the winter and they look forward to. But what's so funny is that everybody has a different way of doing it a little bit. For instance, in my family, we had a lot of vegetables and we'd have things like broccoli and carrots and things that other families definitely didn't have, and we didn't have all the charcuterie, all that kind of meats and stuff. We didn't eat that much meat anyway. So every family does it a little bit differently.
J'avais déjà fait une vidéo sur la raclette, maintenant une vidéo sur les barbecues. La phrase « Eh, on se fait un barbecue », franchement, elle met l'ambiance. Je me disais, c'est marrant parce que de septembre à juin, vous m'avez pas appelé.
Bah non, c'est les aléas de la vie, c'est tout.
Ouais, c'est ça, c'est la vie, c'est comme ça mon petit pote. T'as pas une petite saucisse à dépanner là?
So in this video on barbecues in France, it's so accurate because everybody kind of pitches in. That's the first thing that people say is, on se fait un petit barbecue? Hey, let's barbecue. And usually if you're inviting friends over, there's going to be somebody that kind of designates what everybody is going to take care of, what responsibility they're going to have.
Toi, tu t'occupes du feu. Toi, tu t'occupes du charbon. Toi, tu t'occupes de la viande. Et Norman, oh, tu peux mettre les assiettes en carton.
Yes.
And everybody during the barbecue, they're talking, they're, you know, taking care of everything that has to be done. And again, you know, they have that moment together and then they sit down, they eat together during the barbecue, and that's the time where they laugh, they talk, and so forth. So absolutely accurate in terms of that's, again, some of the meals you're invited over, everything's all prepared, you just have to come and sit down, bring your bottle of wine, your flowers, whatever you're gonna bring for the guests, but you can just sit down and eat. But other times, you're gonna be participating, you're gonna be doing something, and usually the barbecue would be one of those meals where you would do something. And finally, we talked about meals with friends, meals with family, and then there's also dates. Let's talk about meals with somebody that you may be interested in. So an informal date, maybe just you're having somebody over and you're eating. And again, this informality would be not necessarily a sit-down dinner. It might actually just be sitting on the couch, watching something or getting a pizza.
Qu'est-ce que t'as envie de manger, mon bébé?
And next week, when we talk about eating at restaurants and what that looks like for French people, we'll also talk about dates at restaurants. But if you are invited, if you're interested in someone and you invite them over the house in a very casual way, you're just kind of getting to know them and it's kind of informal. Again, you know, if you're inviting them to your house and you're probably, you know, insinuating that something may happen, maybe not, you don't know. But you'll probably get some casual dinner, and the only time it would get serious is if you're inviting that person to dinner at, you're like having that person come to dinner at your parents' house. That's a little bit more serious, but again, it depends the relationship you have with your parents and with that person. But then it's maybe insinuating, hey, we're getting serious, we're, you know, gonna start dating, we're gonna start a relationship.
Hopefully this video and the little clips in between have helped you better understand what it's like to eat in France at someone's house or for you to have French people over your house. Please like the video, share it around you. Don't forget to subscribe to be notified of the upcoming videos you're not gonna wanna miss.